Hi, I'm Nikki, welcome. If you are new here, please make sure you subscribe. I create weekly videos about UX, UI, product design, and design career. In this video, I am going to share with you my favorite plugins in Figma that will let you create design mockups using different devices. So let's dive in. So we are going to talk about three plugins. I'm going to show these to you. So if you don't have them added yet, then this is where you can add them to your Figma file
or your Figma software, actually.
So you just gotta come to the main menu and hover over plugins, scroll down to browse plugins in community, and then it opens up. And this is how you can search for plugins. For example, let's start with Vectary 3D. I already installed it, but you will have an install button here, so you just gotta click that, and whenever you go back to your file, it will be here. So this is our main screen. So we would like to create a mockup and place this screen on a device. So let's do that. So I'm going to start Vectary 3D elements, and it is starting now. We have this beautiful panel here, and it's loading. You can browse through all of these elements. So you have like a lot of abstracts, mockups, different devices, or even a hoodie. You can add your layout to space, some cutesy stuff, an emoji as well, which is really cute. So just play with it and find whatever works for you. So I'm just going to stay in a mockup section. This one actually tells you the layout that you can use here. So let's just give it a go. So we're going to use this mockup, and I am going to click load frame. You gotta select your frame, and I have done that. You can see that it is selected, and then I click load frame. Woohoo! And now this is done. And then you can just click export image, and it is here. It is beautiful. And now you can move it around wherever you want. You can resize it. Okay, second one. This is Mockup Library. It is a pretty good tool. However, to really utilize this mockup plugin, you need to have a pro account. It has so many features, so many mockups if you go pro. Otherwise, you actually need to click this thing. It says free only, and then it just filters the free only versions. So you should give it a go and see if it works for you. It's good enough for me. I'm going to select this one. So this is an iPhone 13. You can change the color. Which one would be complementary to my purple? Oh, maybe this one. Add my content first. You click that. You gotta select on canvas. So you just move this one around. And again, you select the frame, and then you say crop. And then this is done. You can see what it looks like, and you can also change the device color here if it doesn't fit. You know what? Actually, this one I think is nicer. So let's just go with red and paste in canvas. Woohoo! It's so pretty. Look at it. This is so nice. Oh, what did I do? Okay, so, and you can resize it. Make sure you hold down the shift key. If you compare this to the previous one, the colors are truer. See, the hue is better. It might be closer to the design that we're using here. And the last plugin is Mockuuups Studio. I don't know how to pronounce it. So this is like a really good practice. You can see that they always ask you to select a frame. So just select the frame. So I've done that. Again, it has a premium feature, but it always shows which one is free and which one is not free. Maybe you just want to have a different scene. Maybe like somebody's who's walking. I think that's really nice. Export as file and place into documents are the options. I am going to place into document. And we wait. Now you can close the panel. And that is it. And again, I think this is actually truer color again, if you compare that to the first one. Now let's just have a look at all of them. So this one was Vectary, and you can see that the colors are a little bit muted when we place the frame onto a mockup, but maybe this works for you. I think the second one, Mockup, is really nice. I really like that how sharp the edges are on the device, and I really like how they actually use the latest devices, even, you know, if you go pro, then you will have even more options. But this is super nice. And what I really like about this last one is once we place the frame onto the mockup template, then it really kept the true colors. And I like that we can use an image and we can put our design into context. You know, maybe you can use that on your marketing website, on your personal portfolio. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really hope you enjoyed this video and I see you next time. Bye. And hey, if you are not subscribed, please make sure you subscribe to my channel so you don't miss next week's episode.